Hey, this is Agent 355.
And I'm Yappo.
And we're back with episode 3.
And so, I see we have a fancy new border now.
Yeah, I thought you might like the Kawhi Indiana Jones border. With Zelpud over there on the left in his video game shirts.
Is he wearing video game shirts?
Yeah, that is a reference to one of the other creations from the creator of the game. And one of the other games that he made, and Zelpud talks about those all the time if you listen to him. He's always talking about, you know, Japan's stuff and games and jazz.
So you're not buying the shield, are you buying...
I'm showing off that if you ever say no to them, they have different lines and they'll get kind of mad at you, right? And so they have lines for when you say no, or when you leave, or this, and I want to show off this person's lines because they're the best.
All right, so we got a waterproof case for our laptop. So would it be good to assume that we're going for a swim this episode?
Yeah, so watch when I say no to this lady. She gets a little bit mad, and her eyes go red.
I was going to say, the sprite turns.
Now what's even better is watch what happens when I don't have enough money to buy something.
Nice.
Yeah. So the thing with the waterproof case is, well, we haven't seen it yet. There are some areas that might require it. Now, we beat this area. There's a lot more we can do here, but nothing we can do now. So we're going to move on. We're going to explore a bit, and we're finding a new area to go to.
Ooh, fancy.
The game has clearly defined borders between areas. For instance, see over on the right, that's the ladder going up and the symbol?
Yep.
Those symbols and those ladders always mark border changes, and if it wasn't hidden by the rest of the UI, you can even see a little symbol on the wall, on the edge of the screen. Also, those ladders shoot you sometimes. Or the statues. So now we're in a completely different area.
Yeah.
And there's some water.
I do like the aesthetic change.
Every area has its own aesthetics, and like the person in the thread said, they're all based off of different things. While the one we left was very Mayan and Aztec, this one is completely different. And so we want to go. We want to keep going, but as you can see, if we touch the waterfall, we can't move.
But the fish can come out and kill you.
Yeah, we can't. We can't make it over that. Actually, it's not entirely true. If you're really, really precise in the jump, you actually can jump that, but you will eventually be completely blocked. So we can't actually go in here yet. One of the things that the game does is it lets you go to a bunch of places and then says, but hey, you don't have the stuff to get to the places. So I'm also trying to activate that that statue and get it to shoot at me. Because they shoot at you for attacking them.
Apparently he just doesn't give a shit about your shurikens.
But no, right now he just don't care, so... So we can't go that way. There's two more places we can get to from here, and we're going to go to one of them now. This one we actually can go to. I just want to show off that if you go to somewhere where you're not supposed to be, you will run into unbeatable obstacles.
And I assume we get some way to beat waterfalls later on.
Yeah. Sometimes what you'll find is just really difficult enemies or really insidious puzzles you'd have no way of knowing how to solve without information from somewhere else. So you can actually do some pretty serious sequence breaking in this game, because obviously if you know what you're supposed to do, you don't need to have found the tablets.
Right.
So we're headed down this way.
I was just waiting for that to happen.
I was trying to dodge it. I was getting ready. Oh, also, you asked me about these things.
Yep.
These things are actually not pigs. They are, in fact, rats.
Okay.
And they are apparently called Komodo rats. I looked on the wiki, and they're based on Japanese folklore. The page it linked me to about those things was all in Japanese, so I have no idea what kind of folklore it's talking about. I googled it, I couldn't find it, but
okay.
Yes, they're based on something.
Oh, and these things change their attack pattern when you...
Yeah, these things just roll around politely until you try to whip them, and then if they're facing you, they'll jump and they'll dodge your whip.
It's tricky.
So, if you saw the one that we got in this area is called the Mausoleum of the Giants.
So, do we have a giant fight at the end of this one, or...?
Well, what we're here to do is what the skeleton's telling us to do. We have to decipher the riddle of the giants.
That just seems silly.
Well, it makes more sense as we go. So, okay. For right now, this is not a death chasm. There's just a room below us, but I don't want to go down there yet.
That seems like a pretty tight jump, too.
It is a little close. So this looks like a dead end. But not if you are a master assassin of shurikens.
I was going to say, it looks like something where you can smack it open, but...
Just money. Money in the walls.
That big, thick wall there looked super conspicuous.
Yeah. Sometimes it's pretty easy to tell if there's a passage there, and the hard part is getting it to open or figuring out what to do with it.
I assume it's kind of when it's when in doubt, hit it with something.
Yeah. There's definitely, you know, the Castlevania breakable walls thing going on. Whenever you see me running... No, it's not. Whenever you see me running over a skeleton, trying to scan it, trying to remember if it has something to tell me.
Instead of dying to bubble frog things.
Well, you know, they do one damage. I just don't care that much.
So it seems like, from what I've seen so far, any time you hit a switch, it's good to run a little ways away, just in case.
You never know. I mean, now, the thing is, I was just showing off that there is a switch there, and if you hit it, it just does bad stuff. So if the mothers made the giants look tiny, and we are tiny compared to the giants, the mother must be really big.
Nebra Sky Disc?
This is another crazy-looking dude who lives in these places.
I assume this is some riddle for some puzzle.
Yep. Everything means something unless it doesn't mean anything.
Clearly.
Clearly. Oh my gosh, I forgot something. Oh, I'll have to come back. Wow, I can't believe I forgot this. Oh well. I'll get it on the next one. I'll probably even go edit it into the next video. So this is a, it kind of looks to be like an alien, right? Now, if you remember the guy in the thread, he made a post about one of the other things that kind of look like an alien.
Yeah.
And we're going to see another one later that also looks like an alien. Now, I had never really thought about this before, but there's a heck of a lot of alien mysticism things in the game that are based on the real life places.
Yeah.
You know, so all of the ancient civilizations... Oh, so when I hit this, that arrow changes.
I was going to say, what's...
Right? Remember that button that we hit up there?
Yeah.
It was actually directly above that. And previously that arrow was pointing up, but now that button is above an arrow pointing toward the chest.
Oh, so if we go hit that button again, it's going to unlock the chest for us?
Correct. Now, we didn't have to hit it in the first place. You could have come down here and hit that button first. But that
always,
is...
Always press buttons. I mean.
But always press buttons, yeah. And... I always feel like you don't have to know the answer to this puzzle if it's something you can solve by flipping all the switches. Because that just makes sense. So we get the noise telling us that something happened.
Hooray!
Yeah, so this area has a lot of different murals relating to aliens or things like aliens. Time travel and stuff. So that's kind of interesting.
So is this the map for this section now, I guess, or...?
Yes, now if we hit F1, we see we have the map of the Mausoleum of the Giants.
Gotcha.
The Approach of the Giants is the name of the room we're in. It's also worth noting that room is not necessarily just this one screen. It could be four or five screens big.
Oh, okay. That would have thrown me.
Also, I'm showing off here that if you try to whip these guys through the ground, they dodge you.
I thought this was some, like, Mario shit. I thought you were just, like, headbutting the ground, but...
Nope, I was trying to whip him through the ground, because of course you can't hit people through the ground. This is where the Ghost Lord lives. Get you one.
So, I'm trying to guess. So far, based on what we've seen so far, you either got to fight a giant, a Ghost Lord, the Mother, or some crazy alien from a mural. Taking all bets.
Taking all bets. So... Now, this one refers to someone, Magella, who carries a whole lake and then dies. That's interesting.
That seems unfortunate.
I like the carries a lake thing, because that reminds you a lot of like the old folklore sort of stuff, doesn't it? You know, like in the Native American stuff where Coyote is this mystical being who lives in the stars and stuff like that, right?
This looks like a boss room.
Well, this is where the Ghost Lord lives. We're going to get you one. Also, these are the more things you can examine. I hope the guy in the thread tells me what they are, because I don't know.
Which, by the way, great work, whoever, whatever dude, I forget your name, but that's some cool shit. So if you keep that up, that'd be awesome.
And here's another person doing something that sounds, you know, like old folklore. Ouch. That was smart.
You're, like, almost dead.
I am. Now that thing said that the Ghost Lord lives here, and we have to wait. So I'm gonna kinda hang out and wait for the Ghost Lord to show up.
So how long do we have to wait for the Ghost Lord to get here?
Well, I'm not sure. I'm trying to figure out what the riddle told me. The riddle told me to wait, so I'm waiting. But then nothing really seems to be happening. It's just kinda, you get the Medusa heads floating around. Not actually Medusa heads, but you know what I mean, because from Castlevania. So I just said, maybe if I kill some of these guys, maybe something will happen. And I kill that one, and it kind of flies toward the middle, so that kind of looks like something's going on. So I'm trying to kill this one, and I accidentally whip the thing and die. Remember, kids, don't whip the things when the eyeball's in the room.
I figured those eyeballs would do something fun.
Yeah, they zap you when you try to whip things. So here we got dissolve. Okay, we're good. Let's keep going.
Oh, man, look at that pro editing.
Pro as fuck. I actually even found tools to make the audio edit together, so that the audio doesn't make horrible jump cuts either.
Oh, wow.
So one track fades in, the other track fades out. It's great. I'm so proud of myself. So proud of my ability to find buttons. So now we're going to try to kill some of these ghosts and see what happens. Maybe that makes something happen.
It seemed like they got a little angry when you killed them.
Oh, okay. Something's going on.
That looks a little bad for you, I'm gonna say.
It's a big ghost. This is a mini boss. He's really fucking easy as long as you dodge behind him and try to whip him in the back because he goes by.
I'm gonna say this does not look like it's terribly difficult to dodge or anything.
It's ridiculously easy. The trick is don't try to get in front of him, and the timing on the whips is actually kind of tight. Once he starts to disappear, you can't hit him. You have to hit him before he starts to disappear.
It took like half your health off, or?
No, I had been hit before. It took like 10 HP.
What a shock.
Yeah, so there you go. It took 8, exactly. Are you saying I get hit a lot?
Yeah, I'm saying you're kind of bad at this, too.
Ouch.
Swing and a miss.
That hurts. I start throwing shurikens at him. A little easier to hit him with, because the whip is a little tight.
Is this like mecha shuriken here, or?
Kinda. It's kind of an upgrade. It's a rolling shuriken. So, it went to our inventory. There it is. We got 20 of them.
Okay.
So let's put them on and chuck one, see what happens. Cool. I can't say I use a lot of these, but what's interesting is there's a fair number of sub-weapons we're going to find, and they all have their uses. Some of them are really good against certain bosses because of the way they act.
I was going to say, I can see where this would be useful in a few situations, but I don't feel like it would be useful regularly.
Right. Like, for instance, if I want to hit the guy below me, I could do it with this, with my regular shuriken.
You don't, because I'm sure you're...
And nice job, man.
...a video game spurg who tries to save everything possible.
Oh, we didn't get him to him in time. Okay. These clay golems are immune from the front. I gotta jump over the top of them.
I'm just waiting for you to land on that spike strip and die.
Nice thing about the rolling shuriken is it does go through enemies, so...
That's cool. Okay, so I think the clay golems are the first one we've seen besides bosses that take multiple hits from a whip.
Well, I guess skeletons count, right?
I guess. Yeah, but I mean, they're like... kinda
but,
die.
Yeah, but you're right.
So
what's this thing? That looks like a giant, right?
Looks like holding you up there, I guess, but it looks like you're gonna get fisted if you go down to the bottom.
And here's a whole bunch more names. So this is the mausoleum of the giants, right? Now, mausoleums, those don't typically hold things that are living.
Well, clearly we're already past that point, since there's all these worms and bats and...
Well, sure, but those aren't giants, right? Like who's buried in Grant's tomb? right? So, and again, more names. We're just getting all these names from these tablets, but we don't recognize any of them yet. So maybe that guy in the next room next to us is a big giant dude.
Are you going to have some sort of like crazy name-based puzzle that you're going to have to remember what all they did to...
No, yes. Yeah, that's pretty much what's going on. So also notice that now that I've read it, we can teleport back to this place.
Okay, so you can teleport to any of the little ground buildings.
Yeah, teleport up to the surface, and we're going to go heal up in the healing shrine and go back.
Now see, I am disappointed because you got that waterproof case after you went in that little healing shrine for the first time.
Well, the healing shrine's only like ankle deep. Do you use your laptop on the ground or on your lap?
Clearly, it comes up to like his neck in the sprite. So,
yeah, and I actually don't know what happens if you try to use your laptop in the water. I think maybe you just can't open it. Like, if you try to open the menu, it just doesn't let you because you're in the water. Not actually sure. Resembles an astronaut in full gear. So here's more I was talking about, like, the weird stuff, right? That's based on an actual carving that kind of looks like a modern-day NASA dude.
Yeah, and I'm sure there's all sorts of crazy conspiracy theories about this, but...
Yeah.
I just thought it was
interesting that it showed up in the game a bunch.
For being a giant fist that's running around punching things, that seems surprisingly weak.
The trick is, it charges you, and if you hit it while it's charging, it dies in one hit. So if you feel like playing chicken with it, you can just whip it. Or if you want to be cheap, you just throw a single shuriken at it and it will die as it's charging you.
I feel like you're going to have to fight a giant named Bado now.
Hey, look. Boots.
Why is there a ghost merchant?
He says I can't. Well, he says he can't rest as long as you don't buy things. He even told you that when we came into the shop.
And he's even doing spooky, encouraging you to buy stuff.
Yeah, so spooky.
So what do the Hermes boots do for us here?
Deals so big you'll scare yourself.
Wow. All right, wrap it up. We're done here.
So the increase in move speed. Look, we run faster now. Makes it easier to get over those little jumps that I had to go over earlier.
Gotta go fast.
So, we're doing the same thing here that we did in the first video. We're exploring the whole area, looking at all the tablets. Although I realize now I missed some of them in this video, but whatever. The next video covers all of them, even if I ran by some in this one.
Okay, so there's a war between the giants? Is that what I'm getting here?
Yeah! I mean, look, okay, so here's some more, and they're clearly armed. Also, they have spears.
Oh, God.
What is that? Like, oh. I even Googled it, like, trying to figure out, like, if the game makers ever said what they were going for with that animation on the loading screen. And I couldn't find anything. So, and no one seems to want to talk about it.
Did you have safe search off, or?
I always do. So here, again, more giants. And one of the things I was showing out on the map screen, it wasn't just for the animation, but it was called, this area is the Hall of Twilight, or something like that. And if you've been paying attention, one of the tombstones says something about Twilight on it as well. So the name of the room and one of the tablets kind of look like they were talking about each other.
Okay, now that one, so that's that the one came, we saw first. Then.
Exactly. That one came and went really quickly, but it was talking about how Zebu held up the land. So we can kind of figure out that these names are talking about
these
different
guys.
Giants. Yeah, that the different statue dudes. And that maybe there's clues to figure out which one is which, and maybe that's important.
Oh my god, just run into all the ghosts. Don't even worry about it.
Oh god. Well, they're like Medusa heads from Castlevania. They're terrible. They get in the way so often. I was trying to show that you can jump up onto that statue, but I didn't make it. So we're going to take a brief foray outside of this area.
So
to a different area.
Transition.
This is an area transition, so we're going to drop down here for just a minute.
This is quite the different area here.
Yeah, this is very, very, very different. Especially with the lasers on the walls.
Yeah, is that what those are supposed to be?
Yeah, kind of. I don't know. So what I want to mention here is that I'm going down here for a specific reason, and I know why I'm going. But if I was just a regular person playing the game, I would expect people to explore every area, you know, and just like go different places and try to find things. And so this is where you might happen to go down if you were looking for stuff, you know, just kind of walking around. And if you walked around, you might find this place. And yes, this is how you're supposed to find this. There's no clues to come down here. You just have to explore and find this helmet.
You can't buy caltrops?
No, not yet. Huh. Maybe there was a reason I went there in the beginning of the video. Maybe that was to make this make sense.
Well, that's just ridiculous.
That's completely insane.
Prior planning in my LP?
I don't know. That's just wild, right? So, okay, well, so we got the helmet, and there's nothing really else we can do in this area except break some plots and hope they contain valuables.
So are these supposed to be, like, lasers, or, like, pillars that glow, or, like...
It'll make sense later.
Damn it, game. I want to know now!
This is the Twin Labyrinth. This area is a huge dick, because... Wait a minute, this isn't where we were.
Oh, is this the gimmick of this one?
This is not the room we were in, and those aren't normal bats.
Are they vampire bats?
They kind of charge you and stuff, and I don't want to deal with them. So, let's go back down. Maybe the other ladder is where we came down. Maybe I was just mistaken. Well, at least there's an Unctuel up there. Let's go get that. That's clearly the whole puzzle of this area, right? To get the Unctuel, you just have to explore and find it. And maybe it was a really complicated teleporter maze that we just happened to solve.
I feel like this is going to be a trap, but...
Okay, all right. You know what? No, I quit. We're gone.
We're done.
I give up. We're getting out of here.
All right. Bye, guys.
Yeah, fuck.